with the human population increasing, with human footprint increasing all across, animals are being squeezed for space. This generation coming up had to be brave, had to ask questions.
Bagli, darja, bora ache, idea ache.
So, Sumesh, brave age films, you know, sounds very, you know, it brings up something in you when you listen to the word brave age films. What was the idea behind the conceptualization and why did you come up with this whole name?
We were doing a lot of conservation work earlier, and part of that was to educate the younger generation, you know, in schools and colleges about the environment. So that's where we realized ki we need to take more videos and show the kids the jungles and forests. At the same time, I did a trip to Jaldapara, that is West Bengal, and there I realized that there was a lot of man-elephant conflict going on. It's like the jungle is like my hand, so you have, this is the jungle, and in the center the villages were there. So when the elephants were moving from point A to B, C, D, they had to cross villages, and there would be a lot of man-animal conflict where the crop raiding would take place. And this we witnessed firsthand with the forest department. And then we realized ki we live in a world which is far removed from what a major part of India, you know, is going through, in a sense of a lot of people are staying in villages and areas near forests. So that's when we realized we had gotten the shots, we had got the conflict shots, we had seen it all at night, elephants coming in the villages.
Pagli, darja, bora ache, idea ache bora.
So we had gotten the shots of the conflict, we had gone in the night, we would go every night to the forest department and see how the elephants would actually come from the forest areas towards the villages. And the forest department, the elephant squad, had to drive them back into the forest so that they don't come out again. But then we realized, see, elephants are very smart beings. And so a little ahead, probably a kilometer ahead, the elephants would again come in. This took place every night. I mean, this was the life of the villagers and elephants every night. So once we captured this, we really wanted to also show what is the beauty of this magnificent animal. It's not about crop raiding, it's not about conflict. For that, we traveled to, we had a schedule in Kaziranga National Park. And that's where we captured wild elephants, rhinos, the fantastic landscape of Kaziranga National Park, and also showed how elephants essentially are beings of the forest. If they get enough of varied food and, you know, different fodder species, they can actually, they are the gardeners of the forest and they can change the landscape. They pull down trees, they kind of create a clearing for sunlight to come in. So when we saw these aspects, we realized that, okay, elephant may be an important species, but if we don't show the ecosystem, you know, we would not be doing justice to the film we are planning to make. At this stage, probably a couple of months before this, we conceptualized a movie should be made on this. So that's how we planned the whole thing. But if you look at it, coincidentally, the Indian rhino is the flagship species of Kaziranga National Park. And because the Indian rhino got protection, it created a huge habitat for elephants, and elephants thrived over there. Yes, there are certain man-animal conflicts there also, but that generally happens when elephants move from Kaziranga National Park, the protected area, towards reserve forests close by, you know. But then we have a, you know, efficient forest department. So that's where even Brave Age, till then we had not given a name to the company. We had not called it Brave Age Films. When we saw what was happening, we realized that with the human population increasing, with human footprint increasing all across, animals are being squeezed for space. And this is truly going to be a brave age where the biggest crisis or threat to mankind and to every other species is going to be climate change, destruction of forests, you know, extinction, local extinction and global extinction of wildlife species. So this generation coming up had to be brave, had to ask questions. You know, you had different ages. You had the Stone Age, then you had the industrial, I mean, I'm talking about Stone Age is much long back. Then you had the agricultural age, industrial age. And now we thought that this generation has to realize what their natural heritage is. Because it's very easy from one generation to the other for the new generation to not realize what they're missing out. You know, our parents, our grandparents lived in forests, literally. Fresh air, clean water. Okay, there were viruses, but not as rampant and widespread because we had a great quality of life. But the new generation, I mean, they are, it's sad. I mean, today we are living in COVID times, and it looks like the new generation is going to be thinking this is the new norm. But this is not the new norm. This is not the way I grew up, you know. So we have to, it is a brave age. They have to realize, they have to take their natural legacy in their hands. The leaders of countries in the world, according to a lot of us, I mean, we can all see it, are not doing enough to curb the, you know, to protect environment, to conserve it, and the natural disasters in front of us. You know, you're talking about floods, you're talking about drought, you're talking about unseasonal rains, you're talking about viruses going rampant. So definitely it's a brave age, and we have to all work in that direction where we can start. Otherwise, I think we've crossed the tipping point of no return as far as conservation is concerned. This is the time. We all have to come together and begin protecting the environment in every simple and small way we can.